Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this, what is today? Today is Wednesday, February 16th, starting off today with Kirk Franklin and I Smile. It's a great song. I think there's a new platform. So I've noticed that numbers are going up and down, and I'm not sure if that's really happening, but hopefully you're all able to stay on. Sometimes things, they don't like the songs that I pick either. So hopefully you can stay. Today we're looking at Mark 4, moving on. If you remember yesterday, we were looking the last 2 days, we've been looking at the parable of the sower, which sets us up for the following parables, kind of gives us a foundation. Jesus is giving them a foundation for further teaching. So we're looking specifically today at, sorry. Twenty-one through twenty-five. I looked at it in a different place last night. 21 through 25. So if you want to get your Bibles out, let me say good morning to you. Good morning, Barbara and Priscilla. I'm glad you're here today, holding you in prayer. And Donna and Genevieve, welcome. Holding you in prayer this morning. Good morning, Daniel and Yolette. I'm glad you're here, holding you in prayer. And Gail and Celia, good morning. Welcome, holding you in prayer. Good morning, Blanca and Sheila. I'm glad you're here, holding you in prayer today. And Macon and Andrea, it's good to have you here, praying for you this day. Cecilia and Admire, I'm glad you're with us as well, holding you in prayer as we start today. And Janet and Renetta, I agree, Renetta, it's one of my favorite songs too. Holding you in prayer this morning. And Georgiana and Betty, two sisters, holding you both in prayer as we start this day. And Esther, it's good to have you here too, holding you in prayer as we start this day. So we are looking at Mark 4. And starting in verse 21. So if you want to turn there, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick and to be able to gather each day with you as we start our day rooting ourselves in God's Word. And we've been walking through the Gospel of Mark, and today we are up to chapter 4, verse 21. So let's jump in. He said to them, "Is a lamp brought in to be put under a bushel basket or under a bed and not on a lampstand? For there is nothing hidden except to be disclosed, nor is anything secret except to come to light. Let anyone with ears to hear listen." And he said to them, "Pay attention to what you hear. The measure you give will be the measure you get, and still more will be given you. For to those who have, more will be given, and from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away." God's word for us this morning. So this is similar to the Matthew passage that we spend a lot of time on from the Sermon on the Mount in our own church. You know, the idea of you are the light of the world. So Mark talks about hiddenness, and he did that in yesterday's parable as well, that there are things that remain hidden. But in today's passage, he says, but they're not meant to be hidden. Like, they're supposed to come to light. The purpose is for the purpose of Jesus coming, right, was that the people, God's people, all of us, might be able to understand more fully the kingdom of God, to understand God more fully. But he says, we've got to listen, right? We can't just kind of give a nod to something like we're paying attention. So you can light a lamp, right? You can turn a lamp on, but if you stick it under a basket or under a bed, it does nothing to bring light to others. You can say that you have knowledge of the gospel, that you have heard God's word, but if your life does not reflect that, it is almost like you are just hiding it under a bed. Or, yes, I know about God, but if it doesn't change the way we live, if it doesn't change the way that we interact with others, if it doesn't change our hearts, it is as if we are just hiding light. And the scripture says, no, light is meant to be shared. It's meant to illuminate the whole room. It's meant to illuminate the whole world. Christ came that light may not only be in us, but that it may shine for all the world. And the more that we shine that light, the more light there is to shine. But if we hide that light, it's like it's not even there, right? If it brings if the good news goes no further than in my ear, it's almost as if it's not there at all. For those who have will be given more, and to those who have nothing, even what they have, even that small amount, will be taken away. So I chose today's song because I think smiling is one of the best ways to shine light to other people. It disarms people. You know, if you're walking down the street, you see somebody who's really in a bad mood and you smile at them, even if they don't smile back, it stops them to think, huh, somebody took a minute to smile at me and say hello. I think smiling, not fake smiling, I'm not talking about even if you're really in a bad mood, just plaster on a smile. No, I'm talking about joy. Joy that says, even though today is tough, God is with us. God is offering light and love and hope. And the world, my friends, needs this more than ever. And so today, although in Mark, Jesus doesn't say, you are the light of the world, he doesn't say, shine, like he does in Matthew. But he says, we are called to hear the good word and to share that. And how will you share that today? I want us to think about that as you go through your day. What are the ways, if you have received the good news, how are you going to share that? Through your living and through your loving this day. Because I'm telling you, my friends, it matters. It matters greatly. It is not enough to just have head knowledge. It's got to be heart knowledge and knowledge that goes out. Good news is not good news unless it's shared. If it stops with us, how good is that? So today, how will you share God's love? How is God calling you to be light, to illuminate your places of work? And thank you, Priscilla. I know just how much you are offering light and love where you are. That is God's call to each of us this day. So let us go now into prayer. God of light and love, God who is the Word, not the words on a page, but the very living Word that came to us in the presence of Jesus and showed us the hiddenness of God that we did not understand. But now our eyes have been opened, our ears have been opened, and Lord, I pray our hearts have been opened and ready to receive your good news. So Lord, this day, walk with us. Let us be a reflection of your light to all that we encounter this day. Lord, help us to shine. Shine the gift of hope for those in our world that are feeling incredibly hopeless. Let us reflect the gift of healing for those in our world that believe there is no end to the pain. Let us reflect joy, not a fake kind of joy, but a deep joy that comes from knowing that no matter what we are walking through, Lord, you do not abandon us, that you walk with us. And on days when it is hard to smile, on days when we feel that we don't have anything to give, you show us that we can still shine. So shine this day, Lord. Help us to shine your light and your love. We ask all of this, Lord Jesus, in your name, your powerful name, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So friends, shine today, because the world really needs this. And this is what it means to have good news. So shine that good news today. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. I'll see you back here tomorrow. Bye, friends.